गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, मी प्रोफेसर निलेश लिंबोरे, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन झील इंस्टिट्यूट ऑफ मॅनेजमेंट अँड कम्प्युटर ॲप्लिकेशन्स. टुडे वी सी हाऊ टू सॉल्व द सिम्युलेशन प्रॉब्लेम्स इन डिसिजन सायन्स. द प्रॉब्लेम इज गिवन एज इन अ क्रिकेट सीझन फॉर अ वन डे मॅच ए बॉलर बोल 50 बॉल्स. द फ्रिक्वेन्सी डिस्ट्रीब्युशन ऑफ रन्स स्कोर्ड पर बॉल इज गिवन बिलो. दे आर गिवन एज runs per ball, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. The runs per ball maximum is up to 6. And then they also given as the number of balls, that is 15, 10, 10, 4, 8, 1 and 2. It means that there are 15 runs, 15 balls, runs are 0, 10 balls, 1 run, 10 balls, 2 runs, 4 ball, 3 runs. The number of total number of balls are 50 balls, and they ask to simulate the system for 2 hours and find the average runs given in 2 hours by him. They also given as the random numbers, that is 88 03 5 29 28 the and etc. The given random numbers are 12. They also we need to find the average runs in the given random numbers. But अशा प्रकारचा प्रॉब्लेम दिल्यानंतर ज्यावेळेस फ्रिक्वेन्सी दिलेली असते अशा वेळेस आपण दिलेली फ्रिक्वेन्सी ही प्रायोरिटीमध्ये कन्वर्ट करणं गरजेचं असतं. तर प्रथम किंवा पहिल्या स्टेपमध्ये आपल्याला दिलेली फ्रिक्वेन्सी ही प्रायोरिटीमध्ये कन्वर्ट करणं गरजेचं आहे. काही प्रॉब्लेम्समध्ये डायरेक्ट प्रायोरिटी दिलेली असते. ज्यावेळेस डायरेक्ट प्रायोरिटी दिली असेल त्यावेळेस आपल्याला फ्रिक्वेन्सीमध्ये कन्वर्ट करण्याची किंवा प्रायोरिटीमध्ये परत एकदा कन्वर्ट करण्याची गरज पडत नाही. परंतु जर फ्रिक्वेन्सी दिली असेल तर आपल्याला प्रायोरिटीमध्ये कन्वर्ट करणं गरजेचं असतं. ज्यावेळेस प्रायोरिटी दिली असेल त्यावेळेस आपण डायरेक्ट मॉन्टे कार्लो सिम्युलेशन टेक्निक यूज करून आपण दिलेला प्रॉब्लेम सिम्युलेट करू शकतो. या केसमध्ये आपल्याला दिलेली फ्रिक्वेन्सी ही प्रायोरिटीमध्ये कन्वर्ट करण्याची गरज आहे. सो पहिल्या स्टेपमध्ये आपण काय करूया की दिलेली प्रायोरिटी ही दिलेली फ्रिक्वेन्सी ही आपण प्रायोरिटीमध्ये कन्वर्ट करू. देर आर रन्स 0 1 2 3 4 5 अँड 6 अँड नंबर ऑफ बॉल्स आर 15 10 10 4 8 1 अँड 2. द समेशन ऑफ दिस नंबर ऑफ बॉल्स इज 50. So we divide 50 for each frequency, that is called as probability. So probability is 15 divided by 50, 10 divided by 50, 10 divided by 50, 4 divided by 50, 8 divided by 50, 1 divided by 50, 2 divided by 50. So we can write this probability divided by using the calculator. So 15 divided by 50 is 0.3, 10 divided by 50 is 0.2, this is also 0.2, 4 divided by 50 is 0.08, 8 divided by 50 is 0.16, 1 divided by 50 is 0.02 and last 2 divided by 50 is 0.0. Probability always lies between 0 to 1. So if we are taking the addition of all probabilities, this will be also 1. So second step, we need to calculate the cumulative probabilities or addition of these probabilities. The addition is also must be 1 because summation of PI or summation of probability is also 1. So we calculate in second step we calculate cumulative probabilities. Therefore runs 0 1 2 3 4 5 and 6, the probability is given as, or we already calculated in above step, that is 0.2, 0.08, 0.16, 0.02 and 0.0. 0 4. Then we calculate cumulative probabilities. First probability we take as it is, then we add this probability into this probability. This 0.3 plus 0.2, this is 0.5. then 0.5 plus 0.2, this is 0.7. then 0.7 plus 0.08, this is 0.78. then 0.78 plus 16, that is 0.94. then 0.94 plus 0.02, that is 0.96. and 0.96 plus 0.04, that is 1. Probability never exceeds more than 1. So here we calculate the random numbers. Here we calculate the random number interval by using this cumulative probability. We calculate the random number interval. So we write our information in column wise, that is runs 0 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. This is the runs. Then we need to the column of cumulative probabilities. So we also write this column, that is 0.3, 0.5, 0.7, 0.78, 0.94, 0.96 and 1. Here 0.3 means 0.30, 0.50 and 0.70. So we calculate random number interval how to calculate the random number interval. First of all, we multiply these probabilities into 100. Then this becomes 30, 50, 70, 78, 94, 96 and 100. Random number interval must be 0, 0 to 99. So we convert this all cumulative probabilities into 0, 0 to 99. So that's why we are calculating this column. But these columns need not be right in exam. So here random number interval start 0 to, there is the value is 30, so it minus or subtract 30 minus 1 for each upper boundary. So 30 minus 1 is 29. So here we calculate discrete interval or discrete class intervals. So 32, here 50 minus 1 is 49. यामध्ये आपण काय केलं की याच्यामध्ये जे रँडम नंबर्स इंटरवल असतील 0 टू 99, याच्यामध्ये आपण प्रत्येक प्रोबॅबिलिटीला 100 ने मल्टीप्लाई करून आपल्या कॅल्क्युलेशन आपल्याला इजी झाले याच्यासाठी आपण हे कॅल्क्युलेशन केलेले. सो 0 टू 29 प्रत्येक कॅल्क्युलेशन मधून किंवा प्रत्येक हल्ली मधून आपण 1 मायनस केलं आणि नेक्स्ट टाइम त्याच्यामध्ये 1 ऍज इट इज ऍड केलेले. सो 30 टू 49, नेक्स्ट इंटरवल इज 50 टू 70 मायनस 1, दॅट इज 69. देन नेक्स्ट इंटरवल इज 70 टू 77, बिकॉज 78 मायनस 1 इज 77. सो नेक्स्ट इज 78 टू 94, दॅट इज 93. देन नेक्स्ट 94 टू 96 मायनस 1, 95. देन नेक्स्ट इंटरवल इज 96 टू 100 मायनस 1, that is 99. So our random number interval becomes 0 0 to 99. So then we calculate the given demand or given average scores or 2 hours, find average runs given in 2 hours. So by using the following random numbers, we are writing these random numbers and calculate the average runs for 2 hours. So here we write the random number in column. First random number is 88. Then next random number is 3, 5, 29, 28, 48, 65, then 19, 55, 57, sorry, 17, 37, and 82. So we find this random number is lies between which random number interval. So here we write random number interval, then we write runs. So here we find the random number interval, which random number lies between which random number interval. So here 88 random number is lies between which random number interval? Here is the random number intervals. So here we see that the 88 is lies between 78 to 93. The random number interval is 78 to 93, and 78 to 93 the runs is 4. So here we write the 4. Then 3 is belongs to the 0 to 29 and runs is 0. Then next 5 is belong to 0 to 29 interval, 0 to 29, and runs is 0. Next random number is 29 is also belongs to 0 to 29 and runs is also 0. Then next 28 is also belongs to 0 to 29, runs is 0. Next is 48 belongs to 30 to 49. Here we write 30 to 49, and 30 to 49 runs is 1. Then next 65 belongs to the 50 to 69 interval, and runs are 50 to 69 and runs are 2. So next number is 19 belongs to 0 to 29 and runs is 0. Next 55 belongs to 50 to 69 and 50 to 69 runs are 2. Then next is 17 is belong to 0 to 29 and runs is 0. 37 is belong to 30 to 49 and runs is 1. Next random number is 82 is belongs to 78 to 93 and runs is 4. So here we calculate all the runs given by scored by 2 cohorts. So we calculate or add these runs: 4 plus 1 5 6 7 8 9 10 and 14. So average runs is equal to summation xi upon n, that is 14 divided by 12 is equal to 14 divided by 12 is equal to 1.16. it means that the average runs or answer of simulation is 1.6 runs per ball. That is the answer of the simulations. So we can solve the simulation problem by using this technique. If you have any query, then contact me on email ID nilesh.limbore@gileducation.com. या ईमेल आईडी वर तुम्ही कॉन्टॅक्ट करू शकता किंवा 77 09 40 31 15 इफ यू हॅव एनी क्वेरी आस्क युअर क्वेरी ऑन द गिवन नंबर. थँक्यू व्हेरी मच.